Hi guys, we're at Palm Springs, that Thursday night street fair. As you see, it's all lit up with the stars and everything, and it's a pretty crowded place. Pretty interesting artwork from all over. We have, you know, candles, woodworkers, artists, and great food on the other side.
As we talk to a group of Native American artists called Elk Rack Traders.
Hey guys, we're here with Elk Rack Traders, and this is the artist. Native American art form, dream catchers. As you see, a lot of dream catchers. We're going to talk to the artist, find out some of his mediums, some of his stuff out here. I see a lot of dream catchers out here, which is what kind are the most popular ones? I see some with horseshoes. And
You know, it just depends on the individual and their taste. I mean, a dream catcher is going to be as individual as the person is.
Okay.
A lot of times we like to look at it as the dream catcher we make is waiting for the right person to come over and get it. It just may take a while, but eventually the spirit may have the two meet together with it.
Now, is there any actual meaning to the dream catcher? Because I was told by another Native American that different colors in the dream catcher mean different things. And
yeah, you know, that is a very broad question.
Right.
Because there's 500 nations, which means there's 500 different beliefs, and it comes down to clan, family, personal belief on that one. A lot of it's going to be defined by tribal tradition. But let me go ahead and grab one right here. I'll give you the nutshell version as far as the story that is the most consistent.
Right.
We actually started the dream catcher. It's like fry bread. Every tribe claims it started fry bread.
Right.
But where the most common belief is with the dream catcher is this was started in the Southwest. Which nation, tribe, that could be subjective.
Right.
But in essence, it started with a weave gun above a baby's head, what's called a cradle board.
Okay.
And that's evolved over time, mainly in the last probably, consensus when I talk to friends, probably 80 years. And it's evolved to the form you see right here now. And this is kind of a modern development of that old tradition with the weave gun above a baby's head.
Right.
And the spirit right here, or excuse me, the story right here, is that the web worker right here attracts the spirits that bring the dreams at night. And the bad dreams get stuck in the web just like a spider web. And the morning, the good dreams get passed through.
Okay.
And some tribes believe you put a feather down that'll drip down like morning dew.
Right.
Others think that you shouldn't cover that at all. And you should leave the opening completely there so there's a clear path for the good spirits to bring the good dreams through.
Right.
And that's the nutshell version right there. We make it both ways because, you know, it depends on the spirit on there. It depends on how we are, our motivation or our inspiration to make it the time, whether we leave the hole open or put beads there and a feather coming down. It's because, you know, each dream catcher is going to be individual as the person who's going to buy it. It's
true. Okay. And then what about, like, I know a traditional dream catcher is like the one you have.
Well, actually, the traditional one would be a very, very traditional one would have like a wood frame.
Right. So the horseshoes are something, it just...
The horseshoe is actually kind of a modern iteration. There's a lot of Native American ranchers because the way history has gone.
Right.
A lot of people think, you know, hunting buffalo, whatnot, which is a big misnomer. But because of just the way history played out, there's a lot of Native American ranchers, reservations, rural areas. And there's an old tradition, old cowboy tradition.
Okay.
Remember, cowboy's a way of life. It's not a breed.
Right.
And so there's no ranch tradition. You take a horseshoe and you hang it above the doorway of your house. And it has to be right side up because if it's upside down, the good luck gets drained down.
Right.
Well, when you bring in a lot of Native American ranchers, Native American cowboys, they bring in that horseshoe tradition. We have a dream catcher on there. You've got kind of like the meeting of both worlds right there. Or an adaptation of that world. It's kind of a living history thing. It's
what
makes horseshoe dream catchers especially personal for me is that it shows that evolution and survival and adaptation of the culture.
Perfect. And just one last question. I see you have arrows out here and antlers and stuff.
My knives,
knives
over here.
And you have arrows at the back,
yeah,
I guess.
I got to finish these ones. Yeah. I'm wrapping them like the ones over in the corner.
Oh, okay.
We can grab if you want to, but these are knives that I make.
So these are with bone antlers kind of thing?
Well, they're antler. Antler handles. I tend not to use bone. Personally, when I use bone, I think the handles dry out too quickly.
Okay.
I tend to like to use unshed antler.
Oh, okay.
Because it's more solid, it doesn't dry out. And I've got some places when you, right here, the stone points.
Right.
They're arrowhead shaped because it's a little
sharp
shape. Yeah, thank you. Yeah, these are obsidian right here, which was, when you chip those, it's called napping.
Okay.
Because you're doing control fractures, you're nabbing off pieces of stone.
Right.
So I got obsidian right here, agate right up here, some small obsidian pieces right here. They haven't made sheets for them yet, they need to still. But those are those points.
I've seen this at the powwows.
The feather fans, they're called flat fans.
Oh, they are they feather fans or because is there some meaning to it? Because I've seen.
Oh, yes. This is going to have more cultural significance than any of the Dreamcatcher or anything else.
Okay.
The feather fans, this is a style called the flat fan, but there's different ones. There's wing fans and whatnot. Let me get this out of the way. A little like a curtain pulling that back.
Yeah.
The feather fan's considered a direct connection to the old ones. It's probably the most. One of the most revered pieces of regalia as part of the dance regalia, the ceremonial clothing, and ceremony for a lot of nations. And you can have like an eagle wing fan that's been presented by the family. The warrior may have earned it because of just the way it does serving the people. They've seen action in the military. And cases like this, you may just take some feathers or a person's earn the feathers.
Right.
Typically eagle feathers. These are actually turkey feathers. And they may earn it. And then you make the fan out of that. The fan may be passed on. It may be societal, like a warrior society.
Okay.
It may be a part of a cultural tradition. Again, very broad question. I can give just a lot of specifics on there, and it'll fit.
So, guys, this is some of the other stuff over here. These are the knives and the arrowheads out here, the small ones to the really big knives. And I actually happened to touch the big knife. It's sharp. So it's not just... It has a dual mode and a dual use to it. It's just not just to look good, but it's also functional as well. We have the feather fans out here and some Dreamcatcher keychains, followed by some chains. And I'm presuming these are from bone or antler as well, and leather baggies, earrings, feather earrings, and some other animals and stuff, the small stuff out here. So also arrows out here, which are cool, pretty cool.
Guys, don't forget to show the artist some love as well as like, subscribing, follow, hit the bell icon for further notifications.